Hello guys and welcome to CryptoBull. In this video we are going to talk about a couple of things. One of them will be Binance Smart Chain and my opinion on Binance Smart Chain. Second thing, we will talk about Bitcoin pullback, which is happening right now. Many of you are in my Patreon, you are asking me what to do next, what is going on. We will have a look at chart and I will tell you what I think about what is going on and what are my plans. Third thing is I will talk about three different cryptocurrencies which I'm planning to add to my bags in this pullback. But if you are new to this channel, welcome on CryptoBull channel. We are creating videos on cryptocurrencies, crypto tutorials, trading and cryptocurrency price predictions. And if you are interested in my personal low cap cryptocurrency picks, join my Patreon as links will be in description and in first comment of this video. So guys, now let's dive in and let's start with what is going on with Bitcoin. I'm using mostly Hekinashi chart because Hekinashi chart allows me to see clearly what is going on with trend. We can clearly see that by candles, these are clearly showing that we are in a downtrend. If you are trading Hekinashi candles, you are waiting for candle confirmation. It could be two candle confirmations that you could tell that trend has changed. Currently we are going clearly downside. And another thing is if you look at RSI, on RSI we can clearly see that we are already oversold and MACD is going down and it is still very bearish. And answering to your question whether this Bitcoin pullback is over or not, I'm still waiting for Bitcoin to do or to finish this pullback, because clearly in Hekinashi candles it's showing that we are going down and there is still no turn. If you are trading Hekinashi candles, then usually two candles tell you about trend change. Currently still I am very bearish at this, but if we look at 1 day chart, if on 1 day chart it will hit this 50 level, because sometimes when I'm trading this 50 level together with Hekinashi candles, then it could break to the downside. Here you also can see that on MACD the blue line is coming close to red line, and if this blue line will break this red line, this could be much bigger pullback than it is now, and we could pull back even to 35 or 30,000 if this will break, guys. But still at this moment currently I am still very bearish. I'm waiting for this pullback to be over and when it will start turning around, when on 4 hour chart I will start seeing green candles, only then I will start getting more bullish and I will start getting into cryptocurrencies. And three cryptocurrencies which I am planning to add to my baskets or to my already existing cryptocurrencies are following. One is Polygon or Matic, and currently as you know guys they rebranded, this is layer 2 solution for Ethereum, which is Polygon Matic. This is one of cryptocurrencies which I am planning to add to my already existing bags, guys, because I believe that this cryptocurrency definitely will go over $1 and maybe even more. And in circulation we have here 5 billion, guys, and first time, as you remember or who are longer on my channel, I reviewed this cryptocurrency when it was at 1.6 cent. And I believe that this cryptocurrency will be big because this is one of those cryptocurrencies which are really required for Ethereum blockchain. And many dApps are being built on Polygon or Matic. And by the way, I will create one update video on this cryptocurrency because I believe that this one really will be big. Next one which I am planning to add is Basic Attention Token. This is a Basic Attention or Brave browser, guys. We already also reviewed this cryptocurrency on my channel, and this one also, I like this cryptocurrency, I like the project behind it, I like the browser behind it, and that's why I also want to add more of these Basic Attention Tokens to my bags. And third one is Monero, guys. Some of you might say why I want Monero, because many cryptocurrency exchanges are getting rid of it, but I believe that this cryptocurrency Monero one day will be very very big. And if you are in crypto and you are planning to be longer in crypto, I believe that all of us should hold at least a little bit of Monero in our portfolio, because in future we will need it. And I think that when, for example, governments will make their own digital currencies, we will want such a currency as Monero, because nobody will be able to track you, and we all have different expenses which we would like to make or different transactions which we would like to make, and we would not want anyone or any governments to know about our transactions. And obviously, guys, you know, you understand yourself, if governments will implement like digital currencies, this is a huge threat to anyone. For example, if you become rich and governments have a digital currency and you decide to, for example, to do some lawsuit against government or to go against government institution, for example, and even if you are very, very rich, governments can switch off your wealth by a click of mouse, guys, and you are becoming from very rich person, for example, very poor person, just because you are living in digital currency world, where, for example, if we will have such a cryptocurrency as Monero, governments will never know that we firstly have this cryptocurrency or we have this wealth in this cryptocurrency. So as governments or no one else will know where we are doing and what transactions we are making. And that's why I love Monero myself, and that's why I will be keeping collecting or picking up and adding that to my bags, guys, also Monero cryptocurrency. But now let's talk about what I think about this Binance Smart Chain, guys. Firstly, I would like to introduce you or give you a quick introduction to what is Binance Smart Chain. Because many of you, as I understood from my previous video, doesn't really understand what is this blockchain. So firstly, guys, there are two blockchains. One is Binance Chain, and this Binance Chain was created only for B2 or BEP2 token, which is Binance BNB token. And then we have Binance Smart Chain, and on Binance Smart Chain there is protocol BEP20. So as BNB is available on Binance Chain and it is available on Binance Smart Chain, so it is in both protocols. If you are sending this cryptocurrency to your wallet, for example, from Binance cryptocurrency exchange, you can send it only in Binance Smart Chain if you are implementing Binance Smart Chain on your MetaMask wallet or on any other wallets. And now, talking about what I think about Binance blockchain in general, whether it has a future or not, guys, I can tell you one thing, that currently I see that Binance Smart Chain has a future only for this bull run, while Ethereum is very slow and while we still don't have such cryptocurrency or blockchain technologies like Cardano, for example, or while we don't have such blockchain technologies and which haven't started yet, like Polkadot, for example. Until those blockchain technologies are just starting out, Binance Smart Chain can shine, and this is the only time when Binance Smart Chain will shine. But in future, I believe that Binance Smart Chain doesn't have a future in this blockchain technology world, because, guys, you have to understand that Binance Smart Chain is not decentralized cryptocurrency. It's not decentralized, and they are not trying to be decentralized. However, if you will come here and you will read about Binance Smart Chain, this dual chain architecture will empower its user to build their decentralized apps, guys. So these are not decentralized because they are controlled, and Binance team has pretty much full control over these. Binance Smart Chain is not decentralized. To my opinion, I think that Binance Smart Chain is not a threat to Ethereum. Only in this bull market, still Ethereum is moving to 2.0 version, and in 1 year approximately, when they will implement 2.0 version, they will resolve these transaction fees issues, so as there is already Matic, so layer 2, which we already reviewed, which token I'm trying to get, Polygon, which also solves this problem with transaction fees, with speed of Ethereum blockchain technologies. So as Cardano blockchain also is coming out this year, as we know, guys, they are going to announce their smart contract availability and platform, and people will be able to build dApps on Cardano blockchain. So as we are waiting for Polkadot blockchain to start working with these shardings and so on and so forth, guys. So yes, guys, I hope that you found this video useful. If you have a question, leave them in comments. Leave a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel if you're new, and see you in the next one.